Hello friends, today we are going to see some previous year CSR net question which had come from topic, that is a block element. Let's see. So this is the first question which has come in June 2018 exam, confirmed flow marks. That is, there are metal given in column A, that is color is given, and column B is their metal respective. You have to find which metal gives which color. So there are option is there. So how to solve that? That is actually, it is a memory based question. There is nothing we can relate that logic as something like that. Actually, that first is europium gives pink color, and that terbium gives green color. So I have gone through 2-3 reference book where I didn't get that red or blue color, but I get that europium terbium. So the correct answer is europium should be pink. That is, A is correspond to C. We get, that is, in fourth, pink is europium, terbium is D. So C or D, that is, question answer is 4. Actually, red or blue, I haven't got that in which which metal show red and blue color, but the definitely europium show pink color and thulium shows green color. So their option, the correct answer is 4. Next is this is also a 4 marker from a block. Here we have to match that which metal was used in which that application of metal. So here metal is given, and next column is that application of that metal. So generally we can see from here lutetium, europium, cerium and terbium. So here we can reagent oxidation out of all four metals. Generally cerium is a use an oxidizing agent in organic chemistry, which is cerium ammonium nitrate is the oxidizing agent. So C should be first. So you can see C is present in first and second. So here our option is first and third. So next we can see what is there. Remaining three element we have to match. So our answer would be first and third. Next is I previously on my block element video I mentioned that electrolyte which I show metal conductivity, in that europium is given and lanthanum is given. So here only europium which can show metallic luster, so it should be B. So B correspond to 2. So he can see only third option there is B is corresponding to 2. That is, europium is Mi2 of metallic luster, which can exist as europium I2. In this, europium is +3 oxidation state and 2 iodine is present, but for valency satisfaction there one extra electron is present. This extra electron correspond to the electrical conductivity of that metal. Let's see next question. This come in December 2017 4 markers. Their statement is given, oxidation state greater than +3 are more frequent in actinide compared to lanthanide. Some actinides show DD transition, uranium and plutonium, that oxides of these are stable, and some actinides do not have radioactive species. So the first element, the oxidation state, regarding that, this is true or false? The actinides greater than +3 are more frequent. Actually this is true, because some actinides show +4 oxidation state. Actually lanthanides show +3 oxidation state more frequent, and actinides show +4. So this is correct. Some actinides show DD transition, that is not. Actually actinides show lanthanide FF transition. Uranium oxide and plutonium that are stable. Actually this is correct, because uranium 2+ is a uranium occurring in this uranium occur in +4 oxidation state. This is stable. Some of the actinides do not have radioactive. This is wrong, because many of the actinides are the radioactive element. Therefore the answer should be third. Next is calculated and observed magnetic moment of aqua complex lanthanides are 0.35. this is 2 mark question, come in 2017. From all these elements, generally europium and samarium show this exception where there is a difference in observed calculated moment and observed and calculated magnetic moment. So europium show, that is 0 and 3.5, and Sumerian show around. This is observed. This is calculated and this is observed magnetic moment. For Sumerian, that is actually 0.85. That is calculated and observed is 1.4. So our correct answer is europium. Next is metal iodide with metallic luster with high electrical conductivity is. So here we can see last question that I mentioned that europium I2, like that here also that lanthanide show metallic luster. Here is lanthanide I2. Same lanthanide is +3 oxidation state, +2 iodine is there, +1 electron, which gives the electrical conductivity. So here our answer is third. Next is, that is famous example of lanthanide complexes, which is ceric ammonium nitrate. The statements are given, we have to find which statement is correct. So here what is, first is aqueous solution of yellow orange color, coordination number is 10, it show metal to ligand charge transfer, it is diamagnetic nature, correct, we have to identify. First is aqueous solution, it is a color compound because of the ligand to metal charge transfer, so it is correct. Coordination number of cerium is 10, which is wrong because it is icosahedron structure, which is coordination number. This is 2 plus 3. So here actually this is correct answer because the coordination number is 10 here. NO3 is acting as a bidentate ligand, that is 4 into 2, 8 plus 2, which is 10. So this is also correct statement. It show metal to ligand charge transfer, which is wrong. It show ligand to metal charge transfer because cerium is in +4 oxidation state, which do not have any electron for charge transfer. It is a diamagnetic nature. Yes, it is a diamagnetic nature. So correct answer is third, which is A, B and D are correct. Next is uranium coordination number. This comp, we have to find coordination number and geometry. So coordination is actually like that uranium, here NO3 is a bidentate ligand like that. That is six oxygen that is binding from nitrogen from nitrate, which are in one plane, and two oxygen that is above and below the plane, which act as a pyramidal capping like. So your answer is coordination number is 8 and it is hexagonal pyramidal like this. So your answer is 8, that is hexagonal pyramidal and square. Next is g value of cerium +3 and praseodymium +3, we have to calculate. So actually your answer is 4 6 by 7 and 4 by 5. In next page I have shown calculation how to calculate. We can use the g for to calculation for this. We can use this formula, that is 3 by 2 plus s into s plus 1 minus l into l plus 1 divided by 2 into j plus 1. Here value of s is half, while value of l is 3, and j for this configuration is less than half field, therefore it is used as l minus s. So value j is 5 by 2. Here I shown calculation how that we get 6 by 7. Same for case of praseodymium. Here in case of praseodymium the s value is half, because half s value is 1, because one electron place in different orbital, is half plus half 1, l is 5, j is because it is less than half field, error l minus s will be 4, and there I shown calculation how that get 4 by 5, not 4 by 5. So answer is D. Next is, which statement are correct regarding lanthanide? Observe magnetic moment for uranium +3 and at room temperature is higher than calculated spin orbit coupling, which is correct because it show different observed and calculated different magnetic field, different magnetic moment, as we have shown recently that example. Lanthanide oxide acidic in nature, this is wrong because most of lanthanide oxide are basic in nature. I have stated that in my previous video. Stability of samarium +3 is due to half field configuration, but samarium's configuration is 4F6 6S2. If samarium go through +2 oxidation state, it become 4F6. So yes, stability of samarium +2 due to half field, no. Samarium configuration. Sumerian configuration is due to the Sumerian plus 2 oxidation state is not half filled. Actually, 4x is though this is a hot, therefore, this is a wrong answer. It should be 4x, which is a not half filled configuration. Lanthanide plus 3 oxidation state ions can be separated, is when it is correct. So, answer will be correct answer A and D. So, correct answer is A and D, that is A answer. Uranium, correct statement regarding uranium, which is come for 4 mark in December 2015. Oxidation state of uranium is plus 4. It has cyclotetranide ligand. It has bent sandwich compound. It has minus 2 char. The structure of uranium is like that. It is like ferrocene compound. In case of ferrocene, we have 2 CP ligands, but in case we have C8H8 2 minus ligand, and uranium is in plus 4 oxidation state. So, first statement is correct, that is oxidation state of uranium plus 4, that is correct. It has cyclotetradiene ligand. Yes, it has cyclotetradiene ligand as C8H8 minus. It has negative 2 charge? No, it has positive 2 charge, that is C8H8 twice 2 plus, not negative charge. So it has bent sandwich structure? No. So our correct answer is A. That is first and second statement is correct. Next statement regarding uranium, we have to same find the correct statement regarding that. UO2 disproportionate more easily than UO2. UA3 is stable oxide of uranium. Coordination number of uranium is 8 in this compound. UO2 is linear. So I am talk about UO2 first, that is actually it is a linear structure, which is correct statement. In this compound 2 plus 4, you getting what I am writing 2, because NO2 acting as bidentate ligand and 2. So what is coordination number is 8, but here is given that is coordination number is 6, so it is wrong statement. So we have to see which in which option their C is given. So only A option that does not contain C, therefore it should be right answer. We have to check for other also. U3O8 is stable oxide of uranium, as it is stable at high temperature also. And last is UO2 disproportionate more easily than UO2. Actually this is right. What happened, this UO2 in acidic medium gives U4 plus UO2 plus water. So actually this is disproportionate to UO2 2 plus uranium. This compound disproportionate is, therefore the first statement is the correct. Then answer will be A, B and D statements are correct regarding them. So here another question regarding is the statement for ammonium ceric ammonium nitrate. Regarding correct statement is that coordination number is 12 for cerium. Actually this is because NO2 is acting as a bidentate, so 6 into 2 12, so that is correct. It is a paramagnetic, no it is diamagnetic, because cerium is in plus 4 oxidation state, which doesn't contain any electron, therefore it is a zero electron, that is the diamagnetic. It is oxidizing agent. Yes, it is oxidizing agent which used in organic chemistry for oxidizing purpose. Next is reaction with PH3P4 give complex of coordination number cerium. Yes, it did. What happened, this complex react with PH3PO to give PH3PO twice. In this is 8 coordinate, this is 2 coordinate, which gives 10 coordination number. So this statement is also correct, that reaction with PH3PO with complex your coordination number cerium, coordination number of cerium will become 10. Here 2NO3 ligand is replaced with PPH3PO ligand. So answer should be A, B and D, which is B answer, sorry D answer, A, C and D, sorry, because B is not correct. Next is comparison of electronic configurations of samarium and europium. So the statements are samarium is better one electron reductant than europium, samarium is better one electron oxidant than europium, facile oxidation state plus 2 both elements, both display similar redox behavior. So samarium and europium, write down, we first write down so configuration, that is 4F6S2, I am neglecting 5D and 4F6S. So samarium is better one electron reductant than europium? No, because for achieve in case of europium it is already half filled configuration, so it will not accept electron. So samarium will accept electron, because for accepting one electron it will give 4F7, so it can act as a oxidizing, which oxidize the reagent. It undergo itself undergo reduction and oxidize the other substance. In case of europium, it is stable, it will not react with Morley. Both display similar, which is not. The correct statement is A. Correct statement is B, that is samarium is a better electron one electron oxidant than europium, because it require one electron to achieve half field configuration. The next is lanthanide having highest partition coefficient of tributyl phosphate, that is TBP, which is solvent extraction method. In this solvent extraction method, NTBP is a used organic phase used for extraction of lanthanide. I have stated that heavier lanthanides will extract for rather than a lighter lanthanide. As we go lanthanum to lutetium, so heavier lanthanide will elute first, that is lanthanum to lutetium. Here lutetium is there, therefore answer should be lutetium. So in solvent extraction carrying out using TBP, there in all the element the first will extracted is a lutetium. Next is pair of lanthanide with highest third ionization energy is europium gadolinium, europium ytterbium, dispersium yttrium, lutetium yttrium. So all of this element show plus 3, and out of this only 2 show plus 2, that is europium and ytterbium, and remaining, that is gadolinium show plus 3, dispersium show plus 3, gadolinium, dispersium and lutetium. So all show plus 3, but europium and ytterbium are more stable in plus 2 oxidation state, therefore their third ionization energy, that is for growing plus 2 to plus 3, they will not generally favor. They are more stable in plus 2 oxidation state, therefore their third ionization energy is very high compared to their second ionization energy. Therefore the answer will be europium and ytterbium, because they are stable in plus 2 oxidation state rather than go to the plus 3 oxidation state. So I have covered nearly 15 example of previous year's CSIR NET question which come from a block element. If you have any doubt regarding a block or any other topic, comment down in comment section. So if you like this video, please like it, share it, subscribe it. Thank you.